I was 19. I was going to school studying political science. I became ill with very vague symptoms, weight loss, night sweats. I was diagnosed with a rare form of lymphoma called non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. It was a rough road. I came back for my one-year checkup, was found to have a recurrence of the lymphoma, and it was probably more difficult for me the second time. That's when I started thinking that I might actually die. After I completed therapy for the second time, I said, you know what, I learned a lot over the past 2 years of being treated here. I think I need to put it to good use and go to nursing school. When I was initially hired at St. Jude, I was hired to work in the medicine room.
Melinda actually took care of me when I was in the medicine room. We had a bonding moment. One day, my veins were just not cooperating, and neither was I at that point. And I looked up at this very sweet-hearted face, and I angrily said, I'm gonna fire you, and then I'm gonna sue you, in my fiercest 10-year-old girl voice. And Melinda just laughed and said, I understand. I know what you're going through. I was a St. Jude patient as well. It was an incredible moment for me. I had never really thought about myself with life after cancer. And then suddenly, standing in front of me was a survivor.
I think it made her a much better nurse because she's walked in those shoes. She has felt the effects of the chemo and the side effects from it. She has the most positive attitude. She's very much an inspiration to me.
Give me five. Woohoo!
I'm currently working with the Pharmaceutical Sciences Department. I enroll patients on a study protocol looking into pharmacogenetics, and we are trying to further establish genetic inheritance and drug metabolism to better prescribe medications for our patients. Whenever a patient needs any kind of medication, that instead of saying, okay, let's try drug X and hope it works, we can look and see what that patient's body can work with and say, oh, we're gonna give you drug Y in this dose, and that's gonna do what it needs to do. So we're tailoring medicine to the patient. This is the cutting edge of medicine. It benefits our patients directly. And if your child is not going to have bad side effects from a medication due to this type of research, then yes, you're definitely going to be excited about it and sign up with it.
We have to have your consent to go into the study. We have to have your consent to come out.
It's a completely voluntary study. When I meet with a family, I explain the study to them, what the risks are, what the benefits are, how they get results, what they can do with those results. Right now, we're looking at 225 genes that are involved in drug metabolism. We can currently link about 12 medications to two of those 225 genes. The example that I usually give parents is, let's say your daughter, Susie, is enrolled on this protocol. Her DNA is never going to change. Her DNA is her DNA forever. So if we test Susie today for drug metabolism of drug X, and we test her 50 years from now for metabolism of drug X, you're gonna have the exact same results. The patients here will continue to receive benefits way down the road.
'Cause you're a big deal.
I'm a big.
I always wanted to work here because I wanted to give back something. If I can help one person get through a rough day just by knowing I went through it and here I am,